All right, let's get on the field and kick around a bit.
Maybe give it a few more days, yeah?
That's what you said a few days ago when the doctor cleared you.
I don't want to end up like that.
He never had the kind of rehab you had. Your club sent you halfway across the world for the best physios. Plus, Dad's knee was, like, totally blown out. Come on. Getting hurt is part of the game.
Oh, yeah? What would you know about it?
How about breaking my leg when I was 14? Having quack doctors tell me I'll never play again. I learned a bit from that.
Sorry. I didn't know.
How would you?
Look, it's just the level that I need to be at, that I was at. The margins are so slim. Something like this could make the difference. It's a real obstacle, you know?
Obstacles. I lost my mom when I was 8. How's that for an obstacle? How about trying to make it in the women's game while juggling school, practice, travel, matches? Ever tried doing your homework on the back of a bus? Playing 90 minutes, getting home at 2 a.m., then having to go to school the next day, barely able to keep your eyes open? All just for some college recruiter, hoping he might notice you've got some talent. You know, I don't have some big contract waiting for me. All I'm doing is fighting every inch of the way, every day to play the game I love. And there's you, telling me you won't fight right now to get back what you already have?
So this is what having a little sister's like.
Too much?
Nah. Bang on, Kim. Whoa, I think you can bend a few crosses into the box for me. I'm worried I might be forgetting what it's like to score goals.
On a platter. All day, every day.
Yeah, I'm gonna hold you to that.
All right, guys, welcome back to the journey. To start off, we're gonna be back with Hunter, and we're gonna put some balls that she's gonna swing into the box. Jesus Christ, she said all over this already. I've totally missed that one. Oh dear. Anyway, guys. So yeah, in the last one, we finished the story, little side story with Danny. And that was pretty successful. So now it's all about Hunter. And he's come back. Well, he's coming back from his injury. And it's like the beginning of March now. So it's looking pretty good. That's a pretty good ball in that, actually. It's pretty good, guys. And bang. Just go for it first time.
Not bad. Looking pretty sharp.
Well played, Hunter. Different class.
Thanks, Dad. Feeling pretty good.
Yeah? Wasn't talking about you. Still good to go, then? That's great. Groundsman wants his pitch back. You sure you're fit to play, son?
100%.
Good. Already told the club. Expecting you next week.
Va. Alex, welcome back. Come, sit. The medical team, they tell me that you are fully recovered.
Knees just like new, ready to go.
This is like music to my ears. Since you have gone away, this has not been a good moment for this club. Our movement in the final third has been poor. We have no penetration and no chemistry.
Well, I can't wait to get back on the pitch, Dino. It's been the longest few weeks of my life.
This injury, I think, has lit a fire in you, no?
Kind of more worried about you right now.
I cannot lie. The pressure is like nothing I have ever known. Every day, even in the papers, they criticize us. The fans, too, we are behind in the league, and they boo us even when we try hard.
Maybe I can help change that.
There is a dagger above me. The president has lost the faith in me. If we don't win some silverware soon, I think my time in this club is done. Every day, I try to remember why it is I love this game so much. Yes.
Hope I'm not interrupting. Just wanted to say it's good to have you back, Alex.
It's good to be back, partner.
So here we are, first game back. Going to give you the full game against Marseille here. So yeah, it's been a bit of a long 2 months for Alex, but now the time has passed. It's time to get back into the mix of things and finally continue where we... A little bit left off last time, you know what I mean? We didn't get much time, did we, before we got injured and whatnot. So yeah, and... We're sitting, I think, something like fifth in the table or whatever, or sixth. I think it's fifth, actually. But we're, like, only 4 points behind Lyon, who are top. So it's not too big of a challenge, to be honest. But, yeah, and that has got a big goal. Get in there, nice one. So, yeah, you know, we still got it, man. Two months out did nothing. But, yeah. So that's it now. We just continue the rest of the season. But as you can see, pressure is on because they want some silverware. Or at least the assistant manager wants some silverware. So, you know, that's what it's about now, is trying to either try and win the league or the cup, pretty much. Because, like I say, when we joined the club, they were out of Europe having a bad time of it. Kind of thing. So yeah, a couple of months to go left in the season, and that's the way the rest of this is going to go now. So yeah, but that is a good start. Muller, 9 minutes on, do you know what I'm saying, guys? So but yeah, I mean, I just like coming back to the whole injury thing again, like I love how it just happened to be, you know, Los Angeles. We had to just go back there, didn't we? I mean, it makes sense in a realistic perspective as well as the story. But yeah, it's all right. And I don't know what to do here. What are you got? Seriously, what are you guys doing? Okay, I'm gonna try and play Muller in there. He's gone for a shot on target. It was on target. Interesting. He's got his defenders out of jail there because they allowed the striker to run free. Very deep at the moment is Hunter. Not a very active way of playing this. But yeah. So I'm on an 8.7 already. That's good. Oh, 8.8, you know what I'm saying, guys? We'll cope with it. It does invite the sort of pressure you can crack under. Moving forward with some danger to the opposition now they're here. That's all right. Never mind. 8.9 though, so far. So far, so good. Hiroki Sakai. Lopez. Tight scenario here on the ball. That's the thing, is you wouldn't imagine, like, to be honest, the most realistic of the three teams you could have picked, right, for me is Atletico, you know, in terms of what is actually going on, because it's like PSG and Bayern pretty much, you know, the... fly away with it, don't they, pretty much in the league and whatnot, and they don't normally struggle. So Atletico for me is probably more, that's probably why I went for it the first time, because I thought, oh, it would be quite an interesting challenge to do Atletico, to be honest. And that's good. And I did too much there. 9.0 though, still. But the great thing is, they just throw you straight back into the first team. They don't even have to come on as a sub or anything. So that's it's quite nice, that, because I kind of hate it when you have to, you know, be the sub and whatnot, and you have to try and build your way back up. So it's nice that we don't have to do that. Okay, here we go. What do I do? Shouldn't have done that. 9.1 though. 9.1. Yeah, I'm kind of messing up a bit, but I'm getting like a pretty decent rating here. Hunter. Now Lucas Moura. Come on, we should get another goal here in a minute. Looking to create an opening. Ah, crap. That's my fault. They were moving the ball around nicely, but now they've lost it. Maxime Lopez. All right, win it back. It's good. Hunter. And am I? I'm going to go wide. Could be dangerous. And of course, we lose it again. It's cool. It's cool. But Muller is good, though. Muller is good for a partner. Like I said, I didn't get to say much about him, too, you know, because we didn't have much time to play with him originally. But he's good because he just works with you, kind of thing. You know what I mean? I haven't played with anybody else. You know, both times I've done this journey, I've picked Muller both times. Like, I don't really have an opinion on Ali or Griezmann that much, even though Griezmann was still at Atletico, kind of thing. But what I'm trying to say is that, like, Ali, I can imagine him, he just sits behind you, kind of thing. You know, in the midfield, obviously, and just tries to help you there. Muller's just kind of alongside you up front all the time, and you can just, you know, link up with him. But then, like Griezmann, I'm assuming it's going to be kind of the similar situation with Muller, really. But I can imagine it being maybe a little bit different in a way. So yeah, maybe he's a little bit more greedy, like it says. So I don't know, but yeah. Anticipated the direction of the pass and was able to intervene. God, we really could do with a second goal, kill it off. Pretty big game, this one, anyway, as it is. Well, every game's a pretty big game, actually, now, because this is the final hurdle, really, isn't it? The final chapter, now, that we're into. Try and win some silverware, and, you know, we've already won some silverware this season at Galaxy, so it doesn't really matter too much, but we're fighting for our coach now. It kind of shows you how competitive it can be, and the the expectations that are on you at such clubs, I suppose, these days. You know what I mean? You've got all these big teams, such as, like, you know, like Real Madrid, Barcelona, and stuff. Like, they've got, you know, there's a lot of pressure on them because, obviously, you know, such a big club. And basically, you expect them to win, like, a trophy every season, at least, kind of thing. I mean, that's not always necessarily the case, but you kind of come to expect it, in a way. But that's a good ball out. That used to be crossed in. Or not. And I'm going to take that. Oh, never mind. We got a corner. He was on the wrong foot. Missed opportunity from Muller's pass. Seriously. Like, you know, I'm on a 9.4, man. I'm not doing that bad. Possession with that header. Positive play in the wide areas from PSG. Yeah, like, coming back to that, there wasn't really any of that last, you know, in FIFA 17, there wasn't really any of that about, you know, anybody getting in danger unless you be successful or anything like that, you know what I mean? But this season, like, you've got not only this little storyline towards the end, but you've also got, like, the one with Williams, and, like I say, you've seen the cutscene where if you don't make it to the cup final or whatever with him, that's pretty much it, which is pretty crap, honestly. You know what I mean, it's a bit strange, that, to me, though, to be honest. You know what I mean, like, they tell him to sort of, like, pack it all up, like, what are we in like February? I mean, like, season's not over yet. You know, and you've only just, like, freaking signed him, so, you know, he doesn't really make that much sense. Oh my god, we've got a massive opportunity here if we get this ball back. They've sort of regrouped now, it doesn't really matter, but still. And I couldn't even see where the ball was there. I'll take a 1-0 win on this, honestly. It's not been amazing, but we've got a goal, so I can live with that. It's 3 points.
The way you played today, it was like you'd never been away. Full of skill, pace, vision. Your presence has completely changed this team, especially in the final third of the pitch.
That's what I do, bring out the best in other players, just going, doing what the gaffer asked me to do. Happy with the performance, but it was a team effort.
Cheers. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with my performance today, especially for the first game back after injury. But it was a team effort out there.
Would you say you were the link this team has been missing during your absence?
I feel I've got a really good understanding with my teammates, and the fans were amazing, really inspiring. I think the teams above us need to start looking over their shoulders.
Alex, welcome back and congratulations on your win today.
Cheers.
So a bit of training here. We got the gate challenge first off. Back to the really good challenges here. I like these ones because they're competitive ones. So yeah, basically just got to be faster here. And then that's it. And then you've got to try and get through here. Which is pretty easy, to be honest. The thing is, Muller's not the fastest, so you probably end up being like faster than them. If you're up against Griezmann, then it might be a tough challenge. So, oh my god, I've got totally gone the wrong way here. Oh crap. The thing is that I could stop him. Oh wait, no, I've ended up getting it. Wow, really? Wow, I really shouldn't have had that at all. I mean, Ali could be a challenge too. I don't know really, but yeah. I got a minus 1,000 for that. Really? Dude. Seriously. Anyway, one attempt left. And should be able to make it through there. It's not too difficult, that. So there we go. We've got the win. So we'll continue with that one. And the last one is tech team. Score more goals than your opponents. Yeah. This best. I like this one. Now this is more fun. I want more of this in like the next free and FIFA game. Do you know what I mean? Like, this is like FIFA Street style stuff. Look, there we go. Go on. Go on, boys. We're going to win this one. We're going to win. Oh, crap. Got to keep it out. Oh, yeah. Blocked it out. Go on. Yes. Oh, close. Oh, it's going to go back the other way. Oh, no. It's going to go back here. Oh, he's missed that one. That's fine. Oh, wait. They've still got it. Oh, crap. There's like a minute to go in this yet. Oh, no. Is he going to shoot himself? He has. We can't get the ball back at all. And oh crap, that's going to be a goal. Oh, I blocked it again. You know, just a defending challenge for me now. Used to like these sort of challenges in the FIFA Street 2012. That's what it reminds me of. Yeah, I get that. I can't remember which ones are called, but you have like this small goals like this. And you have to try and score through them, and like if you score you get like one less player on your team kind of thing, and whoever loses all theirs first just like wins. So yeah, that's like the whole thing. Ooh, it's still in. Oh, it's an upper net. Oh, what, are you serious? Do not say they're gonna score here. Oh, please don't let them do this. That'd be so unfair right now if they do this. Thank you. Wow, that was the most crappy game ever, but I won with one goal. Fair enough. Anyway, guys, we're against Metz in the next one of today's episode in the away kit. So, yeah, which looks pretty nice, by the way, guys. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, you know what I'm like with these, like, away kits and all sorts of stuff, guys. So, yeah. Anyway, yeah, so highlights of this game. And see what happens from there. Again, another game that we should probably win on paper. Whether or not we do, I don't know. Here we are, though. Whipped in. Yes! That was a great opportunity, that. Take a look at the corner, though. Can we get a replay on that shot? That was pretty good. And the decision is
a corner here.
Ooh, it's bending away, it's bending, but he gets to it, never mind. Needed to be a little bit further away from the keeper, that.
He's put in the corner.
And, ooh, by the defender. It's back out.
Hunter. Neymar. On to Hunter. Now the shot.
Oh, close. It's the best decent chance of the game, that one. And it's taken until when the time pops back up, that is. It's a bit far off-ish. Nearly half-time. So, yeah. There.
2 more minutes to be played then. Added time.
Oh, it's a nice ball through. Come on. It's got to be. Ooh, it was close. The keeper nearly had that. I had all the other side of the goal to aim at. But I took a bit of a risk there, honestly. Not a bad ball through. He went for the short. It came out. And ooh. Okay, it was a little bit further away from the keeper than I thought. But still, I kind of rode my luck a little bit with that. Oh. Good chance, good chance. Oh, nice. I did stop for a moment there because I knew the defender was running in and I thought, well, if he runs to sort of the near post, I could maybe just like cut in and turn him and then maybe go for the bottom corner. But I kind of like almost hesitated a bit, but still went for the shot and scored. So yeah, I was thinking of just going for the shot right there and then, but then I just thought, oh, I'll just stop, but somehow squeezed it through. Let's have a look. Wow, that is actually pretty lucky. That was not my intention, honestly, but yeah. 2-0. Could be an hat trick yet. Anyway, that is the full-time whistle there. So, not bad. Not many highlights in that one, but job done. 2 goals. Nice.
Here I am with today's man of the match.
Obviously, yeah.
Right. I sort of forgot about that, actually. No way I have a match like that without incredible support out there. And that is exactly what I had.
Is this type of recognition meaningless to you, then?
Nah, definitely not meaningless. But I don't spend the whole week preparing to be man of the match, you know? I focus on doing my job the best that I possibly can and helping out the team.
A commendable attitude, Alex. Thank you for speaking with me.
Cheers, man.
Okay, so training, and we got striking competition and net passing challenge. So here we go then. A little bit more competition. Score more goals than your rival. There you go. That's all you got to do. And I think this is the one where, like, the first time I ever did this. Oh, that was pretty nice. Yeah, he misses quite often. So I don't know what that's all about. Oh, nice. I don't know what that's all about, but he just sort of kind of misses a bit. Look, see what I mean? I don't get it. I don't get it. Maybe I think it's just the game's way of just like making you sort of like giving you a chance or whatever. I don't know. But I won that one, so there you go. That was easy enough. And then we got the net passing challenge. On your turn, pass the ball into the highlighted mini net. Tip, try controlling the ball before passing it. Yep, that's something you should definitely do. That's something I have learned, personally. But yeah, so just control it, pass it in. Booyah, done. So he's rubbish. He misses everyone nearly. Look, I just don't, like, get him. Oh, then I miss. Oh, crap. Oh, my. What? Are you kidding right now? All right, there we go. Come on. Oh, crap. He's just, like, right behind me as well now. So I gotta get my act together. Always miss one. What, the ball got in the way? Are you serious? Wow. Thanks, game. Yeah, I'm gonna redo that one right here, right now. Let's have it out. That is total bullcrap. You know what you can just do? You know what? You can just do this and just go straight up to the friggin' thing itself. I mean, it's really not that difficult. If you want to do it quick, you know, you have to just like pass it as soon as you get hold of the ball, but you really don't need to. You know what I mean? I think that's like That's like the whole point. My ball just went into his circle there. That's what she said. So potentially, if you put a ball into his circle, you could like screw him up maybe somehow. But whatever, you know. I'm getting too much into it. I've won. Anyway, guys, we're playing Toulouse in this one. And we're actually top of the league after those two wins now. So, yeah, that was it. We just had to win, pretty much. So, yeah, I don't even know. I don't know if we've got, like, Lyon coming up or something. But if we do, we're going to have to win that one, that's for sure. But there's only, like, 8 league games to go, including this one. So, oh, opportunity that. So we're not far from the end. Ah. That's like the first good chance they've had. That is the first good chance they've had. And we have been just terrible in front. We have not, like, found a way to goal yet. They've defended really well, and then they've come up with this. Ah. Good shot, though, to be fair. Got to come back. It's been scored by Frank Tabanou. He's picked the ball up a full 30 yards out, taking a touch, and then hit an unstoppable shot into the top corner. Stunning goal. 62 minutes played. Oh. I can't believe that. Oh, my God. He was right in front of goal for that. Yes, go on. Oh, what? How have you missed that? Oh dear. So what are we on? 72. Might as well give you guys the last bits of this one. I mean, I think it's probably about gonna be a draw at most, possibly, if we can find the goal. But I don't see us getting much else other than that. So yeah, really need to pull a miracle out of the bag to get 3 points here now. Really need this as well with the end of the season coming up. Oh, well, I didn't think that was going to actually go that way. That's all right. Neymar's been a bit quiet, to be honest, today. We haven't really seen much of him. But yeah, no. I thought it was offside initially, to be honest. Well, I've just checked the replay and actually wasn't offside. It was just on. So, chance here to maybe take 3 points away now. But really pushing it late. Come on, they have defended well. They're proving hard to break down, honestly. And this could be it. What are you doing? Oh, I don't believe it. How has this happened? That was such a good pass yet again. God, I was on like a 6.4, not like a few minutes ago, honestly. I was like, it said, oh, you've got a risk of subbing out. I was like, yeah, okay. And now I'm on an 8.5, bitch. Suck it. So, whatever. What? Don't pass. See what I mean? The crowding is out too much when it comes to their box. So, I think they're just playing for the draw now, it looks to be. Ah, come on. We're not going to get this, are we? The value of anticipation from the defender there. Brilliant from him. Attacking now. 2 minutes added. 2 minutes. To get. I mean, still, it's going to be a vital point. Well, that's if we can actually hold it right here. Holy crap. But, you know what? I'm going up front. Screw it. Oh, my God. How did he miss that? That should have been the 3 points for them. 10, 15 minutes, but he's kept his concentration. Come to the rescue there. That was that was the most luckiest thing, because that should have ended us right there. How he's missed that, I don't know, but we've done well to come back and get a point at least. Anyway, this has been a long-ish episode today, guys, so I'm going to end it there. As you can see on the standings, well, we are a point behind Nice now, so we have to come back. If we'd have won that, we would have been on 68 and it would have been a little bit better, but it's not too bad at the end of the day. So yeah, can we actually have a look at the cup? We got Bordeaux coming up eventually. On the other side there, we got Lille and Monaco. Is probably going to be like Monaco in the final if we get through that. So yeah, that is it for today, guys. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this one. This is pretty much it from now to the end of the season. Like I say, 31 games played. We've got 7 left in the league, plus cup games, and then that's it. We're almost there. So yeah, please do comment, subscribe and share as always. See you guys next time. Take care.